Hello, and welcome to the NORC NASCAR iRacing Series, coming soon from Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin, for the running of the Road America 150, the first ever iRacing road course race for the NORC iRacing Series, here in Road America. As the field begins to roll up here at Field of 20, looking at the starting order, in row number 1, we got number 83, Bobby Sinisky, to his outside of number 72, Brady De La Rosa.
Lining up in row number 2, we have number 13 of Justin Gable, and the number 42 of David Shutt.
And on row number 3, we've got number 37 of Jamie Dominique alongside number 74 of John Berrigan.
And in the fourth row, we've got the number 89 Sean Williams, to his outside number 15 Hunter Combs, and a different car number this week.
Rounding out your top 10, we have 18 of Nathan Duanis and 25 Terrell Baker.
Starting in row 6, got the number 53 of Nicholas Caressel and number 24 of Bobby Chaney.
And row number 7, we get the number 28 for the old man, Cody Miller, to his outside, and number 99, Jordan Miskin.
Lining up in row number 8, we got the Ariadne in a different number this week, and number 1 of Delonte Ballard.
In row number 9, we got Caden Henry, number 41, alongside Nick Osipek.
And round out the top 20 and the rest of the field will be number 8, Wes Graham, and the 44, Anthony Emery. The field makes their way down into the third breaking point of the racetrack, which is technically turn 5, but we're not going to call it that because that's stupid. Here's the look at the race information. 25 laps, 100 miles, 25 laps might seem like a short race, but it takes over 2 minutes to get around this racetrack, so this is going to be a pretty long race, actually. We've got 18 corners here, even though most of them don't run actually corners. We've got 83 degrees here, so it's quite a warm day here in Wisconsin. Pit road speed, 45 miles an hour. This should be a one-stop race.
Yeah, it's a special race. You know, it's the first time this league is going to a road course on iRacing in fourth season. We didn't go there first 3 seasons, so the league has grown enough for us to take on a road course. We have 2 this season, and this is the first one here at Road America. It's a great track. There's a lot of places to pass, and it's gonna be an entertaining one.
Yep. The second road course we'll be going to will be Watkins Glen in about 5 weeks from now. As I take saw a look at the track map here, there's a lot of really heavy braking zones, a long braking zones, especially for these cars. You know, brakes on these cars are not that great compared to the actual road course cars. You know, a lot more horsepower, a lot less downforce, and just terrible brakes on these things. So expect a lot of overtaking for these cars.
And you mentioned 25 laps, and it takes over 2 minutes to complete a lap. These guys are really going to have some discipline because there are no cautions on this road course. So it's a long race. Got to take your time and have some patience.
Yeah, and that's a good point. As we are about to make our way into Canada Corn here, there's no cautions at all for this race. So, you know, you can't really wait for a caution and catch back up. You've got to hustle and make your way to your field as quickly as possible. And also another thing too, with the new particle effects, there's actually a lot of dirt on the racetrack right now. As you actually see all like just dirt and rocks over the place, this track does not have much grip right now outside of the racing line. So this is going to make turn one really interesting. Anyone offline is going to be out on the dirty side of the racetrack. As we come through the very final corner here, getting ready for a start, Bobby Zielinski and Freddy LaRosa will lead him to the green. Bill starts to close up here again, ready for a start. Pace car makes a hard right-hand turn down into pit road here as they head uphill towards the start-finish line. And the green flag's now right underway in the Road America 150.
Brady got a better start than the 83.
Yeah, he got a really good start. Bobby Sinisky throwing a block already on Justin Gable. Here they throw in the turn number 1.
Oh, we got one in the grass. Car. Oh no! Wow!
Pow! And we got several cars.
Multiple cars in the grass.
I believe that was the 37 of Jeremy Demeek, and he completely missed the first corner. That car is destroyed. He pulled a Jimmy Johnson.
Yeah, well, boys, that was his first NORC start, I believe, so it ends rather quickly. It looked like he just missed a corner and just got on the gas so he didn't hit anybody, and he barely missed the leader in the 72 car, which is.
Yeah, Freddy De La Rosa got really, really lucky that 37 cut the corner as much as he did. Otherwise, you know, he would have been bowling for race cars. We hit up underneath the Corvette Bridge.
already a fairly large gap between 4th and 5th.
And you can see already how much dust is being kicked up on the racetrack. There is a lot of dirt right now on the racetrack where a lot of these cars went off track during practice and qualifying. You see, Jeremy Missing already has a lot of damage in front of that race car.
And I mean, that turn one, all these cars so close together going into that, you know, tiny turn one, you're going to have somebody with some damage.
And, you know, you kind of see this in, you know, Formula One races where you see a lot of contact, all these cars gripped up when it's the first breaking point, and we definitely saw that. You know, as you saw the 37 just completely missed the corner, we'll get a replay of that here pretty soon as these guys make their way through the kink. And heading down the Kennel Bombs into Canada Corner, this is also a really good overtaking opportunity here. You can see a lot of snow and dust kind of thrown up as these guys make their way into this corner.
This is a corner you can easily miss the exit on. We got some lag. Anthony Emery, I believe.
Yeah, it's nothing new.
Yeah. He's blanking this week, he'll be blanking next week, and I'll probably be blanking for the rest of the eternity. But take a look. Freddy De La Rosa, who started saying he got a good shot from the start, will lead the first lap. Bobby Solinski is about a second behind him in second. Justin Gable and David Shutt.
That was a long first lap. That just shows you how long the laps are here.
You can already see how much these guys are spread out here. As you see, we got a pass here between. Here comes Bobby Cheney inside. Nathan Duane is here going to turn one into the Mexican corner. Really, and we can also got another overtake behind him.
Down to turn number two. Yep. Bobby Cheney still trying to get that position. Looks like he ain't gonna take it. Yes, he is.
Yep, throwing up some dirt, so we got some more dirt on the racetrack. The 74 also made an auto take opportunity on the one cars. Here's a look at replay on the start of the race. And see, look.
You just clipped the grass.
Yeah, and these things, once you get in the grass, they don't break hardly at all. And that car looks like it never slowed down. Pow, into the tire barrier. This is going to be on board with them.
Not really sure. I guess it just makes the breaking point.
Yeah, he just missed the breaking point and just aborted all together without taking anybody out. Caden's around. Caden's around. No damage as it looks.
Yeah. And, Delonte into the tire barrier. He might wheel hop that.
Yeah, he might have wheel hopped and just totally missed his breaking point and just lost the rear end and went sliding. I think you might see more of that today. Just these cars are really easy to wheel hop. So,
you got Ken Henry here.
It's a replay. I don't know if that's a replay or not, but.
Watch out. And he almost clobbered. I think it was John Barry.
Take a look at the rest of the field here.
You see Bobby Cheney right there. Him and Tyrell Baker both have very similar schemes, so watch out. Watch out and see what's different in
their
cars.
The number.
Recognize them better. Yeah,
well, I believe that the one that Cheney's run is more of a patriotic scheme with the stars and stripes on it, and I believe that Tyrell Baker's run is more of a plain Jane one. This is going to be a battle here. I believe this is going to be the 9th decision between.
So far up front, there's no battles.
Yeah.
This is really the closest one so far. Becoming a side-by-side battle.
There goes 74 of a huge dive bomb.
He's diving him. Got it to stick in 18.
Maybe
went
a little bit wide.
Grass.
Well, you can see like the 74 kicking up some dirt offline. Like the 18 did not have a good line going into turn one. He might have gotten some dirt. There's the battle for the lead. You see Bobby Solinski has made up a little bit of distance on the 72, but he's not really close enough to do anything with it. Now this corner right here, Corvette corner, as we're gonna call it for the rest of the race, it's really kind of easy, kind of wheel hop it going up here because you're going uphill and braking at the same time. The car doesn't really know what to do at that point.
And it's kind of a blind corner. You kind of really don't know when to brake because you can't see the corner on the opposite side of that hill.
And there's a huge hill you have to climb up there. You can't really see the apex for sure for either, so you kind of have to guess. Nicholas Caressel there. There's a here it comes, and here's another pass, another overtake. 70, that's 24, but 24 makes the pass on Sean Williams, and then Bobby Cheney up in her spot.
I'll be changing. He's on the move right now. And oh, there goes. Oh, yep, there goes Terrell Baker.
Terrell Baker off in the gravel. Now, luckily on iRacing, you can get into the gravel trap and you will not get stuck. So people want to worry about beaching the cars. Seeing the 99 turn missing. He's got all he.
Oh, wheel hop the rear. Another wheel hop. Off the rear. Able to save it and keep going though.
Yeah, I'm just going to put more dirt in a racetrack. Ken Hanry, not him.
You can just
run.
See that. It's so easy.
Oh,
to just
oh there, there's Alonte again.
Cody Miller falling off track as well.
This track looks kind of simple, just looking at the track layout, but it's really not. It's strange, and the corners are just very tight and really easy to miss.
Well, you know, that's one thing you bring up, like the track looking simple, but it's definitely hard to drive. Kind of reminds me of Monza in the Formula 1 games. Like, it's a really simple layout, but you get such low downforce on the cars and such tight corners that it's really hard to make it into the corners without screwing it up. And this track is kind of similar where you get these long straightaways and these really tough braking zones. And you see the gloaters just roads are glowing on the 53. As they made their way for turn 1, they're heading their way into the turn 2 here. Ooh, Hunter Combs is going to get a really good run here on Nicholas Kressel. As we got another battle here between the 70
Sean Berry and Sean Williams.
Move him up to 8.
Now here, right here, this is turn 5, or technically turn 3, whatever you want to call it. This is a really good overtaking position, because you're going downhill, brakes are going under velocity. Speed. Oh,
whoa!
It's a wheel spin on 18. Might have came out of that corner first gear. See, we're having a lot of action. Oh,
oh
no, hang on to it.
Nathan! Oh, wow, that was a good save.
Never touched the wall.
Yeah, I thought he was going to nail that concrete barrier there. Let's take a look for the rest of these fields. Here's Wes Graham in the 88, following behind Terrell Baker.
Terrell Baker in 13th here, and a little bit of dirt there.
And got a battle between the 16 and the Ariadne and the 40 Grand Prix as they go for the carousel.
Turn 7 and 8. Coming into 9, which is the kink.
Yep. And this is a really, really fast corner. And if you screw it up, that ball, you know, you're going to hit it really hard and just want to kill it.
Oh, here we go.
Yep, I have a pass here going into the Canna corner. All Ariadne.
Oh, Ari missed it. Oh,
and so did Nathan Duenas.
And the 44 is going to get both of them.
Nathan losing a lot of spots.
I tell you what, there's a lot of dirt going in the Canada corner, especially coming out. Why are these guys just getting offline or getting some dirt on their tires? And, you know, they're just missing the corner.
Justin Gable was complaining a lot about it in practice, saying there's a lot of dirt there. Drivers just going off and kicking it up.
There's a big gap between 4th and 5th.
Oh,
oh
no!
That would have been an amazing save.
That's the worst case scenario right there, is to overcorrect it so you spin out, and unfortunately he was running 5th, now he's going to be running about 8th or 9th, so.
Yeah. He missed it. Oh
no!
He missed it again.
Man. I know, like, he went off track, I wonder how much dirt he got on his tires, and he just completely, like, it seemed like the thing never turned.
In a matter of about 15 seconds, his race turned completely upside down. He was running 5th, now he's all the way back here in 13th damage.
Yeah, NASCAR, and the thing is, you can't really afford to make a pit stop.
Oh, here comes Wes!
Yep.
Nope.
So far, this has been a really kind of chaotic race, especially pretty much a lot of people, except for really the top four, Wes Grimm's and did not have that good of a corner, so lose some position there, I believe, to the 16 of Ariadne.
Oh, here comes Nathan!
Yep, he's got luck there.
Ooh, it's gonna get tight.
Very tight.
And this is a corner you don't want to be side by side in, this is the carousel.
Side by side in the Sausageville.
Yep. And you see offline there's a lot of dirt, but Nathan Duane has made it work. He's going to complete the pass.
West Ham got a good run off. Can't really go anywhere with it. It's the kink. Not really.
Yeah, that's not an opportunity. That's not an opportunity to overtake at all.
Ariadne fishtailing out of that corner.
Woo!
And it looks like the 74 is completely the pass on the 24. So the 74, I believe, is actually one of the cars and went off-road at turn one. Lost a lot of spots. He's starting to make that back up. He's actually one of the quicker cars on the racetrack right now. And I, you know, while saying that, this 72, the 83 are on completely different area code right now. Lap times are about 2 seconds quicker than the rest of the field.
Yeah, those two, I think, were about a tenth apart in qualifying, and third was a second from both of them. So they're proving that it's not just hot lap speed; it's just overall speed. And these guys are just pulling on everyone else. You see third and fourth close to each other, but that gap is getting, you know, bigger and bigger between second and third. And even from first to second, Freddy's starting to get up a little bit of a gap.
Yeah. See,
and this is how it's always been on road racing games. And you could see on F1, when Newark ran on that, Freddy and Bobby were always at the top. They were always battling each other for race wins.
Same with the console in NASCAR. There was a point where these two drivers, like, for three seasons, swept the road courses.
You know, and that's the thing, like, even though it's completely different between console and iRacing, you know, simulation, the skill set, it does transfer over. So, not everything will transfer over, but there is a bit of, you know, skill that will transfer. We've got a battle between the 13 and the 42, just being just Gable and David Shutt.
The Gable did get by Shutt, but the Shutt can battle back here. He might have used up his rears. That's a really important.
Yeah, here comes an opportunity for David Shutt to take the spot back and head in the cannon corner.
He's looking.
That
kind of gave up.
Gable outbroke him. Gable had a great Canada corner there. I think he had a bad exit.
Oh, but the 42 is in the dirt. There's a lot of dirt in that corner, and he got sideways because he got into the dirty section of the racetrack. Oh, he's trying to look back to the inside. Oh, he almost
gave him the bumper.
And David Shutt did not have a good corner at all.
You'll see these guys sliding a lot, though, not only because, you know, the rears are starting to fade, but low-speed corners here are just a lot of wheel spin, a lot of horsepower getting put down, and you got to really learn how to manage that. And it's a really tricky road course, as we have been saying. Mm-hmm. So, and I can't even see fifth from David Shutt.
Yeah, and he's, like, the lap times-wise, like, these guys who... Like, all these guys race on ovals, but any of these guys who got any type of road racing experience are just so much quicker than everybody else as we fight about 15 to 74. Oh, here he goes. He's looking for the overtake going in the third corner. Oh, a little bit of contact right there.
A little bit of a lockup as well.
Undercomb's going to brush himself off and keep on driving.
As I heard the Shenandoah Bridge, I'm pretty sure I butchered the hell out of that name there, but the Cheese Bridge, as we're going to call it, was one of the big old semi-truck. And then to turn five.
Yeah, we got first and second in a little duo. We got three duos for the top six, but Bobby Chaney is trying to make this a trio here for fifth.
Yeah. Underneath the Corvette corner, and Hunter Combs, the car got a little sideways there. He did not get wrecked. But the 74 didn't really close up the gap that much as they head down the hurry downs into turn 8. This is also a nerder corner, has got a lot of dirt in it. And you see, actually, Hunter Combs kicked up a little bit there before he went into the carousel. And they come off the carousel and they're going to line up. Ooh, 74 off track there.
74 looked like he got a way better entry there. He might have a run. Not sure if he'll have a run coming down in the Canada corner, but a little too far back.
Yeah, it's not close enough right now to make the overtake. And you can see right there off course, you see like all the dirt is just built up on the racetrack. Really, this is really just one line through there. With all the dirt has been built up in that one corner, especially. Since 74 is much more aggressive on the brakes compared to the 15.
Here comes John Barry.
Yep. He's going to have a really good opportunity because we're looking at the turn one. He's getting a little bit of a toe of the draft.
He's trying to get as much of a slingshot as he can.
Look for him to pull out right before the braking zone.
Yeah, there he goes. There he goes. He's looking to the inside.
He did break a little later and.
Will he make the corner?
Yep. He's going to get the job done.
Yep.
I'm Barry up into fifth. Well, now he has to go after fourth, which is at least 10 seconds down the road by now.
Yeah. So 74 is going to pick up the pace that if he's going to think about getting up to fourth position.
It's a long race, though. We still got a long way to go.
Like I said, these laps here take about 2 minutes and 15 seconds. So Hunter Cohen's trying to look back to the inside, but wasn't able to drive in deep enough to get alongside of 74. Let's take a look back through the field here. Here's Bobby Chaney. We've got another battle here, but this is between the 89 of Sean Lennon and the 4th of Anthony Embry, who is lagging horribly.
Yeah, the 44 started dead last, so he's made some gains through these first couple laps.
Taking them some dirt there as they come out of turn 8 and into turn 9. As that car, I believe that the 44 put some hydraulics, which I'm not sure how much.
It must be quite intimidating to see that behind you.
Yeah. You just see a car just bouncing around over the place. Like, I don't know if I should block him now or not, because I don't know where he's at.
It does not seem to be getting better anytime soon, that's for sure.
And, yeah, we're only on lap 7 so far. So, yeah, these
well,
laps
8. Are, oh. Remember, that means completed.
Yeah.
I think we might be on lap. The leaders might be on lap 9 by now.
Yeah, they are really quick. And here's the 41. Cannon Henry, he's been strong. That car's actually got quite a bit of damage. And speaking of struggling.
In the grass.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that car, he's dirt.
He's drifting.
Crab walk.
Alright, we got a replay, I think, from lap 1 here.
Yeah, this is a very... Oh, wow.
That's what happened to Jordan Missick. He just totally missed the cornering. Oh, no!
Yeah, you know, if you're going to spend $22,000 on a sim brake, at least make sure your brake pedal works.
I can't believe he didn't blow up from there. There's Cody Miller having a terrible day so far.
Yeah. See what happened to Cody Miller here. And looks like, oh, he just straight up turned to 14, going for the kink. Oh, wow, it was really close on West.
What?
Oh, my God, no one's stopping. He has more damage than just that. I don't know. He looked like he was a lot faster, no spec.
Oh, okay. This is my
Everybody's a lot faster than no spec, Gabriel.
Caden Henry in the way, and boom.
Yeah.
And had no room to turn and hit Caden going off the pace.
Yeah. Here's the 14 Nico spec. We saw what happened to him as we take a look back at the leader. Very did the Rosen and Bobby Zielinski. I'm pretty sure they're in a different state right now compared to the rest of the field. I think they're over in Iowa or something like that.
Canada!
Canada now.
Now they're driving to Mexico.
Yep. But yeah, Freddy DeRosa, we've got about like a 2 to 3 second lead right now over Zielinski. And pit road window should be opening up here pretty soon. These guys go about 15 to 16 laps on tires. A lot of these guys are pretty much split this race in half.
83 has some damage.
Yeah.
In that turn one episode. Yeah, right here. Gable has some nose damage. I think they might have hit.
Yeah, so where is the 42 of David Shutt? It's not there right now.
Hey, Gable's all by himself. I don't know where Shutt is.
I don't see him behind him either. Yeah.
I know.
I've worked it. Who knows?
Yeah. So that's gonna move all these guys up in position. Anthony Emery here has got some damage. It looks like he's got some damage to the left front. It's hard to tell if he actually hit somebody or if that's just lag damage. And of course, you know, lag damage won't be affecting the car at all. If that's what it is. As we see,
Ariadne.
Yeah. Oh,
here comes Terrell Baker.
Nathan Duane is off course. Now, you know, Anthony Emery is Ariotti is somebody we usually see in front, but this is the first time we've seen him on a road course, actually. And so far, it doesn't have the speed that he does on the ovals.
I think that moved Cyril Baker up to 9th, considering David Shutt, and we'll might move him back down to 10th.
Oh, here comes Ariotti. Had a run on 25. Old missed the corner. He's off into the grass again.
Move Trail back down to 10th.
So Ariotti will get that spot back. See, there's Caruso there, who had a really good start to the race, was up 5th, and had two really bad corners. Now he's all the way back here. Oh, Nathan Duane is
going wide.
Yeah, and didn't hurt him too badly, but didn't help at all.
You see the car just not happy going into this corner. You can see it just wiggle. Just so hard to brake and go over such an elevation change and over a bump into a really, really slow corner.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm saying these cars, when they brake, there's a certain point where you're braking just enough, and there's a certain point where you're braking too much. And it's just a fine line, and if you go over that threshold, your car is not driving good at all.
I think Nick Osipek might be the last car on the lead lap.
Oh, actually, this car, actually.
Cody Miller is, that's right.
Yeah.
There might be more, I don't know. He's having a horrible day. We've got Team T's to be here with 83, 25, and 28, and they are bookending the field, and they have one car up front, one car in the very back, almost the very back, and one car in the middle.
Yeah, we saw Cam Henry there. He's having a really tough time, too, which is kind of surprising because Cam Henry, when we did the F1 League, had some speed. And to see him struggle this much on the road course is kind of surprising, honestly. Man, look at those brake rotors.
That's where iRacing and any video game on Xbox is completely different.
Totally different between pedals and triggers and an analog stick and a steering wheel.
But as you see for these top two, doesn't matter what they're using, they're going to be up front battling for the win at road courses.
Man, this is a really good camera shot. These guys make their way out turn 8 into the carousel underneath the Speedville Bridge, Johnsonville Platz. One of the iconic corners of Road America is this carousel, and the kink that follows it.
Freddy is running ever so slightly better than the 83, but ever so slightly every single lap, and it's just his lead is getting bigger and bigger. I think we're on lap 11 right now. We might be getting pit stops in the next few laps.
Yeah, Freddy De La Rosa, he's somebody who does a lot of GT racing on iRacing. He does a lot of road course racing, so he has a lot of experience with this type of racing.
83, on the other hand, does more F1 than GT.
See, Cody Miller here just having a terrible time right now. That car, rear bumper doesn't have any damage, but it might. Here, look at Justin Gable back in third.
That left front damage looks awfully odd.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of hard to tell if he got that from Shutt, and if, you know, Shutt has retired from the race. You know, he had to get it by battling Shutt, but how it happened, well, don't know yet.
John Barry is making progress on third.
And you see, he's pulled away quite a bit from Hunter Combs. It was actually Hunter Combs' turn. Might have a battle between him and Bobby Chaney or Priest. As I go up this front straightaway, one of the quickest parts of the racetrack, the uphill section, this kind of slowed the speeds down a little bit going into turn one. Might not a whole lot. Yeah, I believe that 24, he's starting to get a little bit closer to that 15. As we're getting really close to pit stops and halfway, well, a lot of these guys are expected to pit here within the next lap or so. And even though we're only on lap 11 or 12, the tires are kind of worn off quite a bit. You know, there's a this is a long racetrack, and every lap the tires get worse by quite a bit, just based off the length of the lap alone.
Every corner you're no longer approaching that same corner as you did the previous lap because of that tire wear.
Yeah, every lap you gotta back up the corner just a little bit. Every lap you can't drive in there as deep. You gotta be a little bit more careful as we see the 15 off road a little bit here. 24 starting drawing a little bit closer. But you gotta be a little bit more careful with the throttle coming off the corner.
Yeah, these like hot laps, which is, you know, just watch out, watch out.
He's off the road and he's there's a pass. Yep.
But yeah, hot laps here. I think the front two ran, I think, 2.14s in qualifying, but in race runs, they're running 2.18s, you know, on a run late into this run. So you slow down 4 seconds, 5 seconds. So if you pit one lap before the guy you're racing, you're going to gain, you know, probably like 4 seconds. So that's coming into it. Will the 83 try to undercut Freddy?
Yeah, and that's the thing, like, you'll gain a point, you know, like, I was saying, how long this racetrack is, if you pit early, you know, you're going to gain a lot of time. So if he's able to undercut him, he might be able to get the lead out of it.
But those tires, then, you know, they will have one lap newer tires over the course of the run. There's not going to be any cautions. So,
and one lap here is quite a huge difference. Let's take a look back over the field here. You know, West Graham kind of riding it back. Here's the 53 of Gressel. 99 Jordan missing. Still has a lot of damage. Take a look back to the leader. And I believe I think the 72 and 83 pitted.
Yes, they did. They definitely did. Here's 74 in the pits. You see the 24 in the pits now. Yeah, there's definitely pit stops. 72 and 83 both pitted on the same lap, so no advantage to either of them. Oh, two tires.
We'll see how well that works out. He'll be good in some sections of the track, but he's gonna be really bad in some other sections. And I suspect he took left sides, didn't he?
Took right sides, I believe. He gains like 5-6 seconds by taking two, but at a road course, we'll see how that'll work out.
I'm not sure about strategy, especially if he only took right sides. Most of these corners are going to be towards the right, and having your left side more worn, I don't think that's a good strategy.
Yeah, I don't get that. Here's Lance Bowd once again. Just totally missed the corner out of the kink.
This was early in the race, I think lap 4.
And that's he's been out of it for a while now.
He's been out.
One corner you do not want to miss.
You either hit that corner right or you're off in the grass and heading towards the wall. And whoa.
Well, we got Cody Miller.
This has been an awful day for him. Here comes Gable.
Yep, Gable, he's coming down pit road. He stayed out about an extra lap compared to the 74, where it was just the nearest car on track. To see if the 74 pinned earlier than the 7 and the 13, to see what that does. Here comes Ray De La Rosa, your leader. And you see, he is actually extended the lead on Bobby Sonnison quite a bit.
Gable's going to still be third, as long as it takes four tires, but he's not even in his pit stall yet for a 14-second four-tire pit stop. He's so far behind these leaders. He's just getting in now. He's going to be around 40 seconds behind them.
Yeah, the 72 and 83 are just controlling the pace so well. They're so much quicker than the rest of the field. Now, like I said, Gable, he's going to be racing the 74. The 74, we're watching to see if he comes over this hill.
There he is. Now, Sean Williams coming over the hill.
Yeah, Barry comes to 74.
Your 74 is going to get by him. Yep. I think. Yes, he is.
Yeah, but Gable's
right
got
his tail though.
Yeah, Gable's got newer tires, so if he pushes it, he can get back in front of the 74 pretty quickly. And you see those two signs there? Those are the DRS signs. That's for the Formula One cars on the straightaway. Of course, the stock cars, they don't have DRS.
Oh, Revan, he's flying into this corner. He got a great, he's on break. Yeah, he's on lock up there. He looked like he just flew into there. He had a bad corner because of it.
Yeah, I think he's paying a little bit too much attention to the mirror.
He just got a little squirrely going into there.
Yeah, he's keeping the thing on track, but he's having a hard time on the brakes right now. He's getting a lot of pressure from 13.
Gable looks... not this time.
I think Gable right now pretty much knows he's racing for third. That's how the race has played out so far. They have the front two just have such a big lead that pretty much wants to secure himself third. So I think he might take some time here with the 74 and just not make any mistakes. Wait for the 74 to maybe make a mistake and then pass him. But we haven't seen them race yet till now, so you never know. I think John Barry has been holding some great momentum through this race so far, doing really good lap times to get his way up through the field. So ain't gonna be easy.
Oh, he overdrove that corner. Gable, he kind of missed it too, actually.
Yeah, they both.
Look at all that dirt kicking up, man.
Dirt in that corner is ridiculous. Crazy. #dirt confirmed.
We're up in the. I got two wheels here with Revan.
Yeah, he's really pushing on Chris to try and stay in front of 13, and it's gonna probably undo that race for him very quickly. That position, though, because he is killing those tires, and the 13 is really just kind of washing away for 74 to make a mistake, and that might happen sooner or later.
Kind of taking the defensive line into one.
All right, his defensive line is just simply to overdrive the corner.
Yep. Here he comes. Here comes Gable. Going through some dirt on the inside. Yeah. Looks like he's going to complete that pass.
Yeah, that was the way the 74 was driving here. That was kind of.
Yeah. Gable back in third.
Well, that was kind of entertaining to watch for a little. The 74, he's going to look back to the inside. Is he going to dive bomb here? Ooh, Gable really drove him into this corner hard. Is he going to make it stick? Oh, nope.
Wheel hop and lock up.
That 74 is not close enough to make a move going up underneath the Corvette Bridge. Yeah, I think Gable, he was expecting to dive bomb the 74 and just kind of just overdrove the corner expecting that. See the 74 line coming off of that corner. Heading into turn number 9. Or 8 or something, I don't know.
Pretty much turn 6. Considered 8 by officials, but they also consider 2 turns that shouldn't be turns. Turn 6. This is the real 7 and 8 right here.
Yeah.
Coming into 9. Ink is the leaders. Ready. Holding control of this race, setting the pace, not making any mistakes with 10 laps to go.
Yep, 10 laps to go, and that those 10 laps, they're going to take a while. So.
Oh yeah. That's a good 20 minutes plus.
Yeah, the laps, they take a while. I see Freddy Rose about to put the 99 on the lap down. I believe he's probably put Cody Miller on the lap down. I believe that the 14 and the 41 also go down the lap. I'm actually kind of surprised that the 99 is still running, considering how hard he hit the wall down here. Actually,
he's been missing so many corners. Jordan missing so many corners.
Yeah, he's living up to the
but
name.
But he has speed. So
yeah. When he's on the track, he has some speed. First lap.
Yeah, well, he has some nice speed when he's not messing up because he's still 14th.
I tell you one thing, this racing is making me kind of excited for Watkins Glen later in the season, because this has been, even though the race for the lead really has been kind of non-existent, but the racing for the back of the pack's pretty good.
And Watkins Glen, that's a way smaller track, so these guys will even be more close than they already are today.
Yeah, they'll probably be about 50 laps or so at Watkins Glen, which is double of this race, but it's also half the size, so.
Yeah, Watkins Glen Ford road course is actually a really quick road course. A lot of corners at Watkins Glen have a lot of banking to them. Kind of odd road course, but you can hold a lot of speed through corners there.
It'd be different also if we used the boot. NASCAR, we don't use the boot at Watkins Glen.
Yeah, the boot adds about 30 to 45 more seconds to the lap time. There comes Freda Rosa. You see, just using all the racetrack. Even though he's got a pretty decent lead, he's still hustling that thing around. But you get to see, like, he's fast, but you see how smooth he is. He's not kicking the thing sideways. You know, you don't see the thing really nervous under braking. He's just having a really good pace. As you see, I believe that is Wes Graham coming off pit road. I don't know if that's his second stop or that's the first time he's made a pit stop. I can't believe that car's still running. I just can't get over that.
I think Gable's still going through here, turn 11 into turn 12.
Yeah,
finish his lap.
He's pulled out about 2 seconds over the 74. Gable does have one lap newer tires on that vehicle. Ooh, 74.
Whoa, John Barry.
A little aggressive with the throttle coming out of the final corner.
He's giving it everything he got. He does not have. Yeah, here's fifth, so let's see how far.
And he's on old tires as well.
Yeah, he's on two.
Which is a really bold strategy to use at a road course, but
it's working so far.
Yeah. That's kind of baffling that it is working, but it is.
We still got about 20 minutes to go in this race, though. You know, 9 laps, around 20 minutes, 18 minutes, so.
Those right sides have to be absolutely killed.
The left sides are dirty. Turn two.
Can't even see Hunter Combs.
There he is.
He might get to him before the end.
Yeah, we got about like 18 to 17 cars on the track right now. And this is a 4-mile circuit, so it's really easy for some guys not to be earshot of anyone, really. You don't even see no one close to Hunter Combs at all.
Yeah, to track this big and so much, you know, so much time, so many places to make up time, you're going to see some spread out racing.
Here's two cars that are somewhat close to each other. We've got Sean Williams and Ariotti here. This is a battle 40-some spot. Sean Williams having a pretty decent run. You know, he's got some road course experience. So, having a pretty decent run there in 7th. Ariotti, you know, like I said, we've seen him up front on ovals quite a bit. So, I'm not really sure of his road course experience. He's riding here right behind Sean as I head through turn 9 or turn 8 and then some carousel. Ariali taking a much wider approach in that corner, which I'm not sure how well that's going to work considering how dirty the offline is for this racetrack.
Through the kink.
Down Kettle Bottoms here. Kind of an odd name for this little, and not really a straightaway because there's corners in it, but kind of an odd name for this racetrack.
It's quite the death straight, especially when you're side by side.
Yeah. It's kind of odd, like, it's kind of got these little kinks in the middle of it, and you know, if you're by yourself, you're fine, but you get side by side with somebody, it's kind of like, ooh, this might be
really
questionable.
Ariotti, of course.
Ariotti overshot it and didn't want to destroy Sean. Boarded the corner and gonna get back going.
Yep. Oh. You know, see, we got some cars down pit road. I've got more cars off track coming off the final corner. That is Terrell Baker.
This is a battle for 10th.
Yeah. Tell him one thing, that 18's got a lot of front end damage. I think if we take a closer look at him. Yeah, there he is. Wow.
Yeah, he's been through a war today.
Yeah, that car.
That's not 10th, that's 11th, my bad.
But I'm not sure who he hit, but he hit him with a pretty decent amount of force. So, maybe we can get a replay of that. Oh, here it is.
Oh, there it is. Wow.
Speak of the devil. And it looks
he just completely went wide. Oh, no.
Wow.
Oh, and he's mad.
He's either mad or wheel spins like a lot, but.
Well, and he's off course.
Oh, bye. Damn it. Well, I don't know when the lap this was, but he's made a recovery since Walt meets on the grass in real time, but.
14's got some damage. Yeah, Osipag.
Run it last as usual.
Yeah, let's see what happened to Giraffe Boy. All of them.
Woo!
And. Oh, he killed him!
There's the leaders! The leaders!
What oh my god, I was running afraid of Rosa.
Oh my god. Ready to YOLO the guy.
Oh my goodness.
And what happened to the 53?
Wait, the 53 is on fire.
Great. Yeah, he is polluting the racetrack.
What happened here? Let's watch this. Oh, Nick Osipek was but
is in the way.
Oh,
and he
got
pow.
In the way. Oh, god dang, that's a hard hit. He just got in the way and just missed.
I think the 18 blew up. That
car has
no power.
No, the 18 was having such a good run to get back up there. He was 11th, and looks like that car is done.
Yeah, I think the damage that he had from that one accident with the 53, I think it was overheated the motor. Oh, Wes Grant was on
fire. Well, his car is quite clean. It just has some
not
dirt
anymore.
On it. It has some dirt on it. You know, that can be cleaned off. But when I mean clean, I mean there's no damage. He has done a good job of that. And I think he's going to get up to 12th here, or maybe 11th, with these two being exploded and all in front of him.
This is like a tale of two halves. Like, half the field has had pretty minor problems. Really counted. Ooh, I think. I thought he's gonna miss that corner, but he made that
very big arc.
He's got a better arc there. Thought he might have locked him up on the curb, but nope.
It kind of seems like the top 7 or 8 have been kind of a clean race, and everybody else.
Cody Miller trying to mow the lawn.
Yeah.
Oh, there's his teammate.
Yep.
Lapping him.
I mean, if you go a lap down to Rel Baker or something, anyway.
I don't know. That thing is damaged. He's just having
an awful
time.
That car's damaged, too.
Oh, but he's still out here with his car is on fire, and he is still in this race. He is going to move over to the leaders, though.
Yeah, the smart move.
The 83 waves to him.
Yeah.
They're tracking. His race just turned upside down. He started in the top 5, and now look at him.
And Fraser Rosa, where he had to check up between the accident between Osipek and Cannon Henry. Zelensky was able to make a little bit of time up on him, but of course, it's just not enough to really challenge. About a 4 to 5 second gap between first and second. This right here is a really cool camera. Oh, of course, I was right going to say that was a cool camera shot we get off of. But, see those brakes glow going into turn 8. And then for the carousel. Kind of washing this car, You see, Freddy, he's, above him and Zelensky, you're both using the entire racetrack as we see. How is his car still running?
Fire! Fire! Fire!
It's crazy how, Nathan's car just kind of, gave up and this car is still kind of chugging along. It might not
anymore.
Well, that's his favorite wall. Yeah, he's not giving up, though. You gotta give it to him.
Yeah.
He's going until he can't go no more. And now poor Wes can't see anything.
That's some major keys.
Yeah, this is
right
the worst
there.
Corner not to see in because look, it's so tight you have to slam on the brakes. You did a good job of getting through there though.
Yeah.
Very clean corner. Very good corner. Look at all that dirt. We got a dirt race.
I got dirt, smoke. I mean, there's everything's on this race right now. Kind of waiting for iRacing to update this stuff where they can put debris off the actual cars because I'm pretty sure that'd be everywhere too.
Yeah, especially with no yellows. That would be all over the place and.
We'd be pitting every lap.
Yeah.
You'd have blown tires everywhere.
I think at that point you might have to actually need full horse cautions.
Oh yeah.
Virtual safety
cars. Imagine a full course caution at this track. Oh my lord. Yeah. That'd be awful. Because cautions are what, 4 laps each. And at top speed, you're going around here in 2 minutes. And you're going to be going around here at about 60. You might have about a 15 minute caution. So that's why you don't have full course cautions on. The 15 minute caution would be
really boring.
Unbearable. So
yeah,
got no choice but to have no cautions and local yellows only. You can see the handling on Bobby Chaney's race car right now. It is not very pleasing.
Well, you know, one side of those tires has got 20 laps on them, which here is quite a bit. There's Hunter Combs. I'm actually really surprised Hunter Combs not caught Chaney at all. Considering that Hunter Combs has actually got, you know, his tires, he actually took quite late.
This group is tightened up.
We got a 3-car battle for 7th, I believe. It's the 7th.
Anthony Emery, he did the undercar on these drivers, and he got out ahead of him out of the pits, and he damaged his car again and fell back, and now he's making his way back up there.
Well, I don't see any more smoke on the racetrack. I believe the 53 is bowing blew up. I thought the 16 was going to make an overtake there going to turn 2. He's really close.
Good corner for Airy.
He got a lot of wheel spin. I think he caught that curb really bad. So this one gives some breathing room to Sean Williams as they head into turn 5. Well, Anthony tried to lag past the 16 as he blinks a million times.
Sean Williams.
He missed a corner.
Everybody went off course.
Yeah, 44 kicking up some dirt. As take a look back through the field here very quickly, and then get back to this battle.
Your favorite camera.
Yeah, they never stay long enough. That's one thing we actually did.
There goes Anthony Emery on the inside, and Ari's in the dirt.
Yeah, he's off in the dirtiest part of the track.
Whoa!
Oh, contact!
There was some lag right there or something. Coming off the turn, or coming off the carousel, heading off into the kink.
Anthony Emery making a last minute effort to get up here to get to 7th. Well, it's more like last 8 minutes, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, like 4 laps to go.
Yeah, 4 laps to go, and that takes a while. And off in the cannon corner, this is probably the dirtiest section of the racetrack right
here. Emery gaining.
I mean, you can see right there how dirty the track is. It's like how dirty it is. And see, you know, Ariadne did not get a good corner.
Neither did Emery.
Yeah. Sean Williams had actually had a really good entry there.
He's always been the type that's been really consistent, not really making any mistakes, just kind of running his race.
Yeah, Sean has a quite clean car on that.
Yep. Taylor Swift would be really happy that her image has not been screwed up at all on that car. But that last corner is quite interesting. You get a really kind of weird entry in the corner. You're turning and braking at the same time. So you kind of have to really kind of strain the car up to have the make the most out of your braking going into that corner. And you know, if you come off the brakes kind of wrong going in that corner, the wheel just breaks out. So we've seen a couple guys go off into the dirt coming off that corner. As the things should be clicking over here to 3 laps to go, Fraser Rocha should be pretty close to the start finish line. There it is.
Yeah, that's how far these guys are back in the lead. How good Freddie has been today. These guys are in turn 4, but it's technically turn 6, coming to turn 7, and Freddie's coming out of turn 3, so.
I thought one of the 44 was always going for a corner, but
he wants the position of number 7. Yeah, he wants to get by Sean Williams. But you know, Sean Williams ain't going to make no mistakes, so.
He's close.
He's there though.
I guess the fortunate thing for Sean Williams, the 44, is not currently lagging. Well, of course,
not as bad as he has.
Yeah, where he had like hydraulics, you know, jumping up and down, and shit.
Yeah.
Got a little bit off course there, but didn't hurt him too bad. So getting back at the Canada corner.
Aries really dropped back. Maybe he just wants to let them race it out.
Yeah, these two have definitely picked up the pace racing the shutter. Coming off of turn 13 and into the final corner, and you see the 44 almost, he really charged that corner, almost got in the back of Sean. Might have wheel hopped it just a little bit. As they come up here to get three laps to go. Terrell Baker kicking up some dirt.
Yeah, all that dirt.
And a car that's somehow still running. Here's your actual leader.
Look how much dirt there is. This is nuts.
Can you imagine if we did this with like 40 cars and all the dirt? That would be everywhere.
Yeah, so the battle for the lead, we never had a side-by-side battle. It's just been a tug-of-war the whole race so far.
Yeah, really, the start is what kind of won the greatest race. He got the really good launch. As we got two laps to go.
Nearly got killed on the start by Jeremy Dominique.
Yeah.
I could have changed the entire complexion of this race. If that was big junk in turn one, taking out maybe these top two.
Mm-hmm. And you'd be looking at Justin Gable as the leader. Bobby Zielinski in second. There's a car I don't understand how it's still running.
He's running good times. Not doing too
bad. The damage he has.
Yes.
Here's Ferg. About a full minute behind the leader. 74 and 4. Let's kind of take a look at the field here. Bobby Cheney still hanging on to 5th. Hunter Combs in 6th place.
Hunter Combs is looming. He's coming to 2 to go. Try to get to Cheney.
Here's a battle right here between. This is really kind of the only battle on the racetrack right now between these three guys.
These three.
Sean Williams really goes wide.
There's the mistake and it's gone. Oh, he's getting everything out of that corner. Anthony Emery's coming after it.
I think he kind of made a last ditch effort here on this white flag.
There's an Ariadne just kind of hoping these two take each other out. He's close enough to capitalize on it if something were to happen. Going uphill. And this is going to believe that is the battle for 7.
You know, Terrell Baker, he's gone through some crap today, but he's going to end up with a top 10 as long as he can keep it on the track.
And that car looks relatively pretty clean as we head back to the, really not much of a race up front. It looks like Zielinski kind of closed down the gap a little bit, but not a whole lot.
These guys are just so equal, but Freddie's just that much better, though.
Freddy's there it is. White
taking
flag.
Taking the white flag, Freddie De La Rosa.
Four miles to go.
Yeah, he needs a average 4 miles to take this win. Average 4 miles without any mistakes, and he has it.
Yeah, he's got a 4 second gap on Zielinski, so he just needs to make sure, even though he's still pushing that car, actually still running some dirt on the racetrack. But he just needs to keep the rhythm up, make sure he doesn't wheel hop going in one of these braking zones, and he'll have it. Zielinski definitely not close enough to make anything happen. Afraid that Rosa will have to screw up, somewhere, and you might have to do a couple times before Zielinski can be there to him. Into the braking zone in turn 5.
Oh.
I mean, he's still hustling.
He's really pushing.
I mean, he's got a big enough lead. Maybe he thinks, if this keeps going the way he's been going the whole way, I'll just keep the ribbon going. Because that can happen to some people where they'll back off and their ribbon gets screwed up and they'll make mistakes if they do that. So maybe this thing can just go all out. He's made some contact with somebody.
Doesn't seem to be affecting him at all, though.
No. Yeah, that kind of damage, especially how slow this racetrack is with the corners, that shouldn't hurt him at all. And it hasn't, really.
Maybe might even help him, who knows.
Into the kink, the fast, well, the one of the fastest corners of the racetrack. Yeah, still about a 4 second gap. Fredo Rosa going to can in the corner.
Freddie ran a flawless race, really.
Yep, he won last week at Richmond, and the chaos happened there. And he's going to come off of turn four. As long as the motor doesn't explode, he has it. And I don't think he will. And he's going to make the final climb up the hill. And here he comes. Frey De La Rosa will win the North iRacing Road America 150 here. Bobby Zlinski will take home second place. And we're going to wait quite a bit for third. A really, really good win. Really good job of driving by Frey De La Rosa. And also a good job for Bobby Zlinski. Really being the only person in the same zip code as the 72 is to see
one last time he goes wide.
Might as well.
I believe he's going to end up with 12th, though, out of this. Out of 20 cars, you know, he survived. Yeah, actually, 11th. He's ahead of Wes Graham. I think he might be 11th. I'm going to have to wait till the final results. Here is Justin Gable to complete the podium.
Yep. Yeah, Gable, he'll come off of turn 4. Really, the only challenge he had was the 42 and the 74. 42 lagged out, and 74 got next to him for the pit road cycle, pit stop. Piss up cycle, but he will take home third. Almost a full minute behind the leader.
Comes Sean Berry.
Yep.
Sean Berry will end up fourth.
And that's good actually his first top five of the year, and it comes down to road
course. Bobby Chaney somehow survives on that tire strategy. That was very odd.
Yeah.
He'll get P5.
Yeah, Hunter Combs was actually finding there a lap or so. Hunter Combs, he really cashing up there.
I think that was Jordan Missick behind him. Or was that Hunter? No, that was Hunter.
Yep. Yeah. And then he'll cross the line in sixth place.
Fifth, my friend.
And all right, fifth.
Hunter Combs, sixth place.
Uh-oh, and wait, there's no pass here.
Wait
Ari
a second.
Ari is passing.
Oh, wow. Ari's going to get seventh. We did not know. We didn't see what happened. We need a replay on this. Sean Williams and Anthony Emery are going to round out your top nine. It looks like Sean Williams is going to get eighth.
Yeah, both these guys were in front of Ari Audi, and they're quite a bit back behind them.
And rounding out your top ten, the last car running, last car running to the finish, that is.
Yeah, he's got some damage, actually. He's made some contact with somebody. But it's not going to affect the finishing position of Terrell Baker. So, yeah, we're going to take a look at the replay, see what happened to 89 and 44 in the last lap. Coming to the line, there's Terrell Baker. He'll take Brown out the top 10. And only 10 cars on the lead lap.
Yeah, Cody Miller will finish 12th. Wes Graham, 11th. The rest of the field is just about exploded.
About to get air is. Yeah, they were. This is the last lap here. Right here.
Yeah, this is the last lap between these.
You can see the gap between them and Ariadne.
And
Sean made a mistake.
Sean went wide.
Overdrove the corner.
He made a mistake. I jinxed him.
Emery was putting on the pressure.
I'm gonna see what happens at the 44.
Oh, I think Emery got a little bit excited here.
Yeah,
he did.
Overdrove the corner.
And it's
really
gone
off the grass.
And they both just gave up two spots to Ariadne.
Yep, and Ariadne will take the position.
He's like, I'll take that 7th place finish for the race I had. Thank you very much. Bye.
Here's the finishing order. Frey De La Rosa with 3 seconds over Bobby Zlinski, and it is almost a full minute back to Justin Gable. 56 seconds back. John Berry will be 4th. Bobby Chaney, a minute and a half, 90 seconds, round out the top 5.
In P6, we got the number 15 of Hunter Combs. Ariadne, number 16, finishes 7th. Sean Williams and Anthony Emery are 8th and 9th. And Tyrell Baker is P number 10.
Take a look at the rest of the field. We got Wes Graham 11th and Cody Miller 12th. Like I said, Nick Ostapek survived and got 13th. Jordan Missig 14th. Russell 15th, Duanis 16th. Caden Henry looks like he left early after dying many times, 17th. And I don't know what happened to Shutt really, but he got 18th, and Dante Ballard will be 19th. So I don't know where 20th is, but
that'll be Jeremy Dominique, who completely missed turn one at the start.
Yeah.
Really, that was the only action that happened up front, was right into turn one, lap one, which is kind of like happens in really in F1 races. It kind of happened here. But yeah, really good drive by Freddy De La Rosa. Led all 25 laps too.
Yeah, he said before the season, he said, this season I want to challenge Bobby Zielinski for this championship. And I think he's made a statement right here, winning back-to-back races, that he can do that.
Yeah, great run by Freddie. You know, he was just, he dominated the race, really. Even though it was only 3 seconds to second, it was he led every lap and he set the pace and he did everything he had to do. It's a good run to him. A good job to Bobby Chaney taking two tires. It ended up working. He got a top five out of it. And everyone, it looks like top 10. It says they weren't a lap down. Top 10 did a good job. And heck, I'll give a shout out to Wes Graham. You know, I don't think he had a single dent on that car. So, and he ended up with 11th. So good job to him.
Yeah, for the very first NORC iRacing road course race, that was pretty exciting to watch. I mean, like I said, really wasn't that much of a battle up front, but we had a lot of action, you know, everywhere else, really. A lot of cars.
These kind of races are different because there's no cautions at all, and you get to really see who's the guy who wins fully, you know, deserves it because they didn't need a caution to catch up. They just straight up went start to finish and were the best. And Freddie deserved that win completely, and it's good to see it's good to see road courses, really.
Yeah, I'm very excited for Watkins Glen later in the season. It should be a phenomenal show. Way smaller track, should be even tighter than the racing was today.
Yeah, I think it's about six races away till we go to the Glen. So that should be fun to watch. But next week we got Talladega.
Yeah. Not only just Talladega, we get the dual races at Dega, which is actually, instead of one 94-lap race, we'll have two 74-lap races.
47.
Or 47, whatever, you know what I meant.
We got interesting races coming up with Talladega duels, Pocono, Martinsville, and Dover. So that's a real interesting mix. Hopefully we'll see some good racing.
And a lot of wrecks.
Well, we'd like to thank everybody for watching the NARA NORC broadcast, and we'll see y'all next week for the Duels at Dega.